to someone I love. My faith in your reality, it keeps me hanging on.
Hey folks, what's going on? Hope you're all enjoying your 2-week self-quarantine. It sucks. You know what else sucks? Biting. And there we have today's topic. It's probably one of the most important things to understand in breaking and in art in general. So, first, what do I mean by biting exactly? Basically, it's taking someone's move or style and passing it off as your own. Now, this is a really simplistic definition to something that's often seen as black or white, but it can get quite complicated. First, let's address the elephant in the room. Everybody takes things. Everybody, quote unquote, steals. That's how anything gets created in this world. That's how creativity works. That's how human civilization has arrived where it's at now, by taking things and building upon them, reworking them to fit in a new context. As a beginner, you have no frame of reference, and so it's only natural to take from any source you can get. Copying and mimicking is built into us as humans, and we all start doing this from the time we're babies. It is fundamental to learning and creativity. The key part to creativity in art is that we don't just take things and leave it as is. We take them and build them into something else. We evolve it to the point where it's unrecognizable from the original source material. This is the distinction between inspiration and, in the hip-hop world, what we would call biting or copying. I can be inspired by a dancer and like the way they do things or even specific movements, but I don't do them and try and call them my original movements. That might get you some oohs and ahs in the short term, but sooner or later you'll get exposed. Now, when breaking first started, there was only a handful of people doing it, and it was a little easier to see who created what, or if someone really did bite or take something, it could get addressed much easier because it was such a small community. Now, breaking is an international dance with people doing it in almost every country in the world. How then do you keep track of who came up with what first and who's biting whom? The short answer is you can't really. With this many people doing things, there's bound to be overlap in thinking and creative processes. And while there's always going to be lazy people who are looking for quick results who bite, there are also people who spend lots of time developing something unique. And sometimes two or more people might think of the same idea or concept. It happens. For example, you know that little thing called the theory of evolution that Charles Darwin often gets credited for? Well, there was another guy named Alfred Russel Wallace who came up with the same theory independently. If something as complex as the theory of evolution can be thought of independently by two different people, then your crappy chair Buddha thread might not be as original as you think. So how then do we go about differentiating between the creators and the biters? Well, I think it really comes down to a pattern of behavior. Sometimes it's really clear when someone's biting, but other times it's not. And Jaromsky of Massive Monkeys put it really nicely in one of his workshops. He said, if you see someone's style changing rapidly or changing often really quickly, chances are that they're biting. With someone who's truly developing their own unique style, you'll be able to see a pattern and evolution of their style. Evolution is slow and comes about over many iterations, so it takes time. This does, however, make it difficult to spot biting in the short term, like over the course of a competition. That's when it gets a little gray and sometimes people slip through the cracks, but I think people have to think long term. A real biter isn't going to last. They'll get called out or caught up in their own lies or just leave the scene altogether because they were never in it for the long haul anyway. Hopefully, after some negative experiences, they might even begin to understand the importance of actually developing your own style and expression and change the course. But these are the lofty goals that we've set for ourselves in breaking in particular. Don't look like anyone else and be completely original, even if that's not possible. It's this beautifully strict rule that has led to the creation of such an incredible range of movement and ideas. Humans are incredible creatures. Put an obstacle in front of us and we'll use our creativity to find a way around it. Bottom line, biting and originality is complicated. Like most things in life, it isn't black and white, but more gray than anything else. The best things you can do, though, are take inspiration from everywhere, not just your particular art that you focus on. And more importantly, just be honest with yourself. Give credit where credit is due, and chill your ego, too. We don't own any of this. None of these moves are really yours. When we all die, we can't take these moves to the afterlife, so just relax. It's just dance. There's so much more to say, but I don't want to ramble any more than I already have. So if there's anything that you feel I didn't address in this video, feel free to leave a comment and hopefully we can get some good discussion going on there. As always, if you like the video, please give it a like and share. Hit the subscribe button and the bell to get notifications whenever a new video goes live. If you're really getting something out of this and want to support even more, please check out my Patreon page and toss a few bucks my way. For as little as $2 a month, you can get a thank you in the video and even help guide the content for the channel. Peace, everyone. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay filthy.
Hey, now that old man Peterson's off our backs, let's have some fun. Everything is damaged that could take a bite out of you. Look at the damage. It's going to bite you.
Sandwich took a bite out of me.
Oh. Here's the real way to eat chili. Tim Horton's Hearty Chili in an oven-baked bread bowl with a medium coffee and donut, just $5.59. Also available in chicken stew.
Hey, I ate the ball. I'm never going to eat you. Come on.
Just